हाई फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ लेक्चर नंबर 31.2। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द सर्किट ऑपरेशन एंड वेव फॉर्म्स ऑफ थ्री फेज हाफ वेव अनकंट्रोल्ड रेक्टिफायर। सो सी दिस रेक्टिफायर, हियर थ्री डायोड्स आर कनेक्टेड इन पैरेलल, दैट इज D1, D2 एंड D3, एंड ऑल दीज डायोड्स आर कनेक्टेड इन सच अ वे दैट दे हैव कॉमन कैथोड and their cathodes are connected at node A. Here we know VA0, it is the phase voltage of phase A, and this phase voltage is equals to Vm sin omega t, and it is applied to diode D1. Suppose VB0 is the phase voltage of phase V, and it is equals to Vm sin omega t minus 120 degree. It is 120 degree phase shifted, and it is applied to diode D2. And VC0 is the phase voltage of phase C, and it is applied to the diode D3, and it is equals to Vm sin omega t minus 240 degree. So here this Vm is the maximum phase voltage, and if we have to write the RMS value of phase voltage, then it will be equals to maximum voltage by root 2, Vm by root 2. And what is phase voltage and line voltage relation? Phase voltage is equals to line voltage by root 3. So all these are the basic concepts. Now we will start the main topic. As I already discussed in my previous lecture, that if two or more diodes are connected with their cathodes connected at a single node, then diode with maximum potential will conduct. Now we will utilize this concept here. These are the three waveforms of phase A, phase B and phase C, and they are phase displaced by 120 degree because this is a balanced three phase system. This red waveform is for phase A, that is VA0, that is equals to Vm sin omega t. And this blue waveform is for phase B, that is equals to VB0, that is equals to Vm sin omega t minus 120 degree. And this yellow waveform is for phase C, that is equals to VC0, that is equals to Vm sin omega t minus 240 degree. Now see carefully, from 30 to 150 degree, that is omega t is equals to 30 to 150. We can see that waveform of phase A is the highest. It means waveform of phase A is at the top. It means VA0 is greater than VB0 or VC0 from 30 to 150 degree. So here VA0 is highest. So only diode D1 will conduct, because VA0 is applied to diode D1. So in this case only diode D1 will conduct, and we will get output voltage V0, that is equals to VA0. Similarly, from omega t is equals to 150 to 270 degree, we can see that waveform of phase V is at the top. So we can say that VB0 is greater than both VA0 and VC0. So only diode D2 will conduct, because VB0 is applied to diode D2. So we will get output V0 is equals to VB0. So here you can see that we get output voltage V0 is equals to VA0 from omega t is equals to 30 to 150, and we get VB0 output voltage is equals to VB0 from omega t is equals to 150 to 270. Now see, from 270 to 390 degree, it means omega t is equals to 270 to 390. We can see that waveform of phase A is at the top, waveform of phase C is at the top. So it means VC0 is greater than VB0 and VA0. So only diode D3 will conduct, because VC0 is applied to diode D3. So we will get output voltage V0 is equals to VC0. Now suppose if load is R-type, means load is resistive, then current and voltage waveforms will be similar. This I have already told you in my previous lecture. So So this is the waveform of current for R load. For highly inductive load, current will be constant. This has also been told to you in my previous lecture. So for highly inductive load, you can see that load current is constant. This is waveform of current for RL load. So operation of this rectifier circuit is very simple. In next lecture, we will find the parameters for this same rectifier circuit. Till then, thank you. Jai Sri Ram.